So I'm getting deeper into the Blackstone Fortress. I've spent my lost tech to get some new codes for the mag lift and kind of move in there. I'm penetrating deeper and deeper. No spoilers in this podcast, but I want to share with you some hard-won perspectives, some interesting perspectives, tactics of the game, although I guess I shouldn't be sharing these with any of my competitors out there, but it's been interesting playing Blackstone Fortress, not only to explore the narrative or another side of 40K, a faster way to play 40K. On a side note, in many ways, and you guys know, like, I'm dedicated. I'm there for regular 40K, whatever that means these days. But Blackstone Fortress has captured my imagination as a side project, as a solo game, because this is the experience, this is the 40K experience, the triple threat package that I've wanted for a long time. I love Dark Heresy, the role-playing game. We pull that in with Blackstone Fortress. There's a narrative. There's a mystery. I didn't cheat and look at any of the vaults. I mean, excuse me, the strongholds. It's going to be what we see. The other fan content that comes out, we've already got Harlequins to go up against, some fan-made stuff on there. I'm not getting ahead of that. I'll fight that when I get there. Plus what Games Workshop is releasing. I feel like I'm in a Living Black Library novel. I also love Kill Team. I love small, elite, individual models. And just if there's one or two traitor guardsmen, rogue guardsmen there in 40K, big deal, right? Tabletop 40K, there's like two guardsmen there, big deal. Skirmish, Kill Team, that's a big deal. You're like, I cannot take that next hit. It's only a flashlight, but I cannot take that hit. Roll those dice. Let's see what's going to happen. Capturing all of that is very, very intoxicating in Blackstone Fortress. Games Workshop just absolutely nailed this. So the first thing I realized, and it's kind of funny because I'm playing Blackstone Fortress like it's 40K when it's not 40K, but it feels very familiar. And that's what is the problem with playing 40K. What the heck do I mean by that? What I mean by that is, based on the scenario, whether it's an exploration or an ambush, again, absolutely no spoilers, I am trying to kill everything that appears. So the initial spawns, I'm going to just blast them on everything. Any of the reinforcements that arrive, I'm going to blast them on anything. Now, okay, I'm going to try and build up the destiny points or whatever on there, certainly. But I realized, do I really need to do that? I haven't lost any of the adventurers yet, but I've taken some, I was going to say mortal wounds, grievous wounds. I've taken the hurt. It's come close. Now, there's a difference between getting a little bit greedy and searching and extending yourself, pushing the randomness out there. When I've done that and I got burnt a little bit, okay, that's fine. But the lethality of the game feels like I'm almost playing Advanced Dungeons & Dragons with how lethal it is. Even if you are doing everything right, well, let me backtrack that. Even if you are playing very conservative, I'm sticking together as a group. I'm looking for choke points on there. I have, based on the matrix of the layout for the Blackstone Fortress, I try to have a side area that if someone takes some wounds and I lose the action dice because I don't want to burn my destiny dice, then can I like spend a die to move them literally out of the line of sight, out of the fire on there? So kind of cycling some of my adventures forward, sticking together as a group, target priority, all that type of stuff. Even when you're doing that, you can get really, really overwhelmed with the things that happen. That's before we get into events. That's before we get into just the random nature that hits you in the Blackstone Fortress with some of the events while you're in the middle of combat. It is lethal. So what I started noticing is, you know, in regular 40K, you have the mission and you're doing two things. You have the mission and you're trying to prevent your opponent, the other player, from completing the mission. Well, I complete the mission by sticking to mission parameters with units at the right place at the right time. And the way I prevent my opponent from completing the mission is by removing models. So there is this mindset in 40K where kill everything. Remove models. Destroy your opponent. And in my army lists, 40K, my Berserkers of Scalathrax, Cornate Glory, it's simplistic, but there is an art form. I run across the table and put you to the bolt pistol and the chainsword. With my Samhan Warhost, Eldar, speed is key. I will look to pinpoint units and focus as much as my fast-moving long-range army on that in the moment and then shift somewhere else. So a lot of fluidity. Two exact opposite play styles, but I am looking to remove models. I am looking for you to take lots of models off the table. I have to be overly aggressive to do that. Well, that kind of, it's gotten me into a little bit of trouble in Blackstone Fortress. So now I'm looking and saying, okay, if it's not the ambush, and I know where the maglev or the transporter, whatever it's called, I'm spacing right now, the exit point. If I have to find exit points, then can I just grab some of the exploration points? Can I just grab the tech, draw a discovery card, and get out of there? Do I really need to hit up all 4 points? Look, I'd love to. If I can go node by node, you know, the Blackstone Fortress is random, yes, but without any spoilers, analyzing the maps as you play, it's kind of like there's 3 or 4 or 5 nodes, sections, that are either directly joined or indirectly joined by smaller pieces. So I'm going to try and go node by node, and I'm going to try and occupy the center of each node simply I don't want to get outflanked on there. There's a lot of outflanking, especially with the behavior AI of some of the units in there. I need to be aware of that. But with that, do I really need to clear everything out? Be conservative. Grab what you can. Pay attention to the dice. Pay attention to the wounds. Pay attention to the initiative track. If things reinforce and it's mad crazy, get out of there. Get out of there. If it's not mad crazy, push it a little bit more. I don't need to win. I don't need to win everything, clear everything, and remove every single model. And as soon as I realized this, every dive into the Blackstone Fortress is a success. It's moving me a little bit closer to clues, a little bit closer to the lost tech on there. Not as fast as super win everything, but I don't want to lose some of my initial heroes on there. You know, I'm trying to keep the losses down because the base encounters are brutal enough as they are. As soon as we're going to get into the strongholds, as soon as we're going to try and push into the vault on there, I don't know if I'm going to start losing characters. So I'm really trying to play it by the campaign on there. I'm really trying to be very cautious, knowing that if someone goes down, they go down and they're out on there. Of course, you know, one could say some of my least favorite characters lead with them first, kind of use them as I don't want to say wastoids, but use them as initial clue finders and stuff and push them to the adventure. But then, you know, you're not getting the upgrades, and you're not getting some of the lost tech on them and the experience on them. There's a lot of openings on there. But that's the first thing, tactic. Discovery. Discovery would be better, a better description. The first thing that I discovered with Blackstone Fortress, I got to get out of that regular 40K mindset. It is 40K. There's a familiarity about it. I'm playing 40K. But it's a different type of 40K on there.